angles in closed figures. Hello friends. Today we will learn about the angles that are formed in closed shapes, that is, angles in closed figures. When Reva and her elder sister Meena were sitting in their garden and talking to each other, Meena asked a question to her sister.
Reva, just take a look around. Can you tell me which all objects you see around?
Yeah, sister. A table, a chair, a flying blue kite in the sky, and of course, this delicious jalebi in our plate.
Yes, Reva. If you look at this chair from front and then from above, then you can see these shapes. Similarly, if you look at this table from above and this kite from front, we will be able to see different shapes.
Yes, sister. This plate and these jalebis also have shapes.
Yes, Reva. You have identified it correctly. Now, can you tell me which of these things have corners in their shape?
Corners? What are corners, sister?
Do you know what are corners?
Look here, Reva. If I join two sticks like this, what appears in between is called a corner. But if I take one stick, there will be two endpoints on it, which means there would be no corner there. That means when two lines meet at a point or cross each other at a point, then a corner is formed there.
So sister, does this mean that corners are only formed in objects like kite, table and a chair? And the shapes of jalebi and plate do not have corners?
Yes, Reva. Do you know that when two lines join along with each other, then only one corner is not formed, but something else is also formed, which is called an angle. Where there is a corner, there is an angle. And this angle is something which is very useful.
Really? How is that, sister?
The angle tells us the extent of rotation between two lines. The more the rotation, the more the angle. Now look here. If I join another stick to these two sticks, then a triangle is formed. Can you tell me now how many corners and how many angles are present?
Sister, from what I understood, three corners are formed here. And since there are three corners, only three angles are formed.
Absolutely right, Reva. Come on, we will form a figure with four sticks of equal length. So here are your four sticks. And here are my four sticks.
Then Meena and Reva formed figures with their sticks and showed it to each other.
Did you see, Reva? There are four corners in our figures and these four angles are formed in four different corners. Still, both have different shapes.
Oh, yes. But why is it so, sister?
Because the angles in both figures are different. Just look here, the angles in your figure are like this and the angles in my figure are like this. Because of different angles, the shape of figures are also different. So don't you think angles have their own importance?
Yes, sister. Now I got it. If there is a change in the angle, it will result in change in the figure as well.
Perfect, Reva. Come on, let us identify the angles in the figures we have seen around.
Just like Reva and Meena, can you also identify the angles inside the shapes of different objects? In this video, we have learned about corners, angles formed in them, and the angles formed in closed figures. Did you observe that the angles in figures identified by Meena and Reva are closed figures, just like this triangle and rectangle? Do you know what are closed figures? Are angles formed only in closed figures and not in open figures? What do you think about this? Reva and Meena will answer these questions in the next video. In the next video, we will learn about closed and open figures and we will see some interesting examples on angles. Thank you.